Turkish authorities have issued arrest warrants for over 100 people allegedly involved in constructing many of the buildings that collapsed in the earthquakes.
Along with two other engineers.
Consulting engineer.
And mistakenly approved by the structural engineer.
In today's video, we're going to address an important question. Is civil engineering the right career choice for you? Whether you're a student considering your options or someone looking to make a career change, it is essential to understand the key factors to consider before embarking on this path. We're going to be exploring three crucial topics: the academic requirements and specializations in civil engineering, the job prospects and market demand, and the work environment, salary, fulfillment, and challenge that come with the profession. So as you might know, civil engineering is a profession that requires you to go to university. The fee for a civil engineering course in Australia is around 30K, but it's even higher for international students. Some countries like Brazil, where I did uni, offer free university if you pass a test, which can get highly competitive. The early years of engineering typically involve foundational courses in mathematics, physics, chemistry, drafting, and basic engineering principles. That being said, if you don't enjoy numbers and equations, you might be setting up yourself for failure. I'm not saying you need to love or be obsessed with differential equations, because let's be honest, 99% of the engineering professions will not require you to know calculus or linear algebra. I'm just warning you that at least 2 years of your life, you will be studying these disciplines. And if you're going through this now, don't get discouraged if you fail a subject. I started uni at the age of 17, very immature, and did not do well in many disciplines. But at some point, it will get better and you will get through it. The second part is choosing your career path. In my opinion, civil engineering is one of the broadest types of profession. You can become a construction manager or a site engineer, a geotechnical engineer, a civil engineer, a structural engineer like me, or you can even branch out and work for a bank in finances or become a billionaire CEO of Louis Vuitton. The options are limitless. My 2 cents on this stage of your life is to experiment as much as you can and don't feel pressure to pursue a career in the first field you get a job. My final year of university, I was committed to become a geotechnical engineer. I did my thesis on that. I started taking on all the geo subjects and neglecting everything else. Little did I know that I would never work as a geotechnical engineer. So my advice to you is to open your mind for all experiences and different opportunities. The next topic is job prospect and market demand. Before we dive into it, it's worth noting that the job market can vary based on factors like location, economic conditions, and individual qualifications. I'll give you some key points to consider in Australia because it's the market I'm more familiar with, but you can do your own research and see if these points apply to your location. So here they are. Infrastructure development. Australia has a strong focus on infrastructure development. This creates a demand for civil engineers to design, construct, and maintain these structures. Australia's growing population necessitates the expansion and improvement of infrastructure, such as roads, bridges, and utilities. Civil engineers play a vital role in managing these projects and ensuring sustainable development. Government investment. The Australian government allocates significant funds to infrastructure projects aiming to boost the economy, create jobs, and enhance the quality of life. This ongoing investment provides a steady stream of opportunities for civil engineering professionals. Regional development. Civil engineers are needed not only in major cities but also in regional areas. Government initiatives focus on decentralization and regional development, which opens up job prospects in smaller communities. Mining and resource sector. Australia is rich in mineral resources, and the mining industry requires civil engineers for infrastructure development, mine site rehabilitation, and environmental management. Australia is experiencing a skill shortage in the engineering sector, including civil engineering. This shortage opens up opportunities for qualified qualified professionals and their initiatives to attract and retain talent in the industry. Now, the last topic we're going to discuss is the work environment, salary, fulfillment, and challenge that come with the profession. Before we dive in, I have to warn you, some parts of this topic are very personal and can vary from individual to individual, and it can get quite controversial as well. So I would love to hear your opinion on the comments below. Let's start with the work environment. Depending on the branch of civil engineering you choose, you might work entirely on the construction site or entirely in the office, or with a mix of desk work, site visit, and meetings. I personally find the right balance between site visits and office work is ideal, but it is quite difficult to find this balance. If you're a site engineer, you're going to be the majority of the time on site. If you are a design engineer, you're gonna be the majority of the time in the office. My suggestion is try both of them and see what works best for your personality, and then you can make a call. Now let's talk about salary. Civil engineering offers competitive salaries that can vary based on factors such as experience, location, specialization, and industry sector. In Australia, the average salary for civil engineers ranges from 70k to 130k per year, and higher salaries are often associated with experience, advanced qualifications, and managerial roles. Now let's touch on a hot topic. There might be too much of a gap between design liability and salary. An engineer that signs off a project is liable for that project for its lifetime. In other words, it is a demanding job, there's a lot of pressure, and it demands a lot of time. It might be hard to go home and turn it off like you can with other jobs. Next in our list is fulfillment. Civil engineering can be fulfilling for individuals who enjoy problem solving, creating tangible structures, and making a positive impact on society. Seeing your designs come to life and contributing to the development of infrastructure that benefits communities can be highly rewarding. You will have the chance to work on projects of various scales and complexities. I personally find really cool to walk past a building that I designed, and I will make sure I tell everybody that I designed that building. In summary, civil engineering offers a dynamic work environment, competitive salaries, and opportunities for personal fulfillment. However, it also presents challenges related to project complexity, risk, stakeholder management, and continuous learning. I think with the right skills, mindset, and passion for the field, civil engineering can be a fulfilling and rewarding profession. If you have any questions, just leave a comment below. And if you're curious to know if ChatGPT AI can engineer a house, watch this video next, and I'll see you next time.